introducing a forex dealer at MyForex Fintech Private Limited. So today's topic of webinar is understand the nuances of forex conversions with real arithmetic and tools available to safeguard yourself. So guys, before proceeding, let me tell you one thing. Being a forex dealer, after interacting with lots of banks on a regular basis, most of the time I feel banks tries to overcharge their clients while converting their forex conversions. Okay. Why banks tries to overcharge their clients? Because of the some reasons like lack of rates, transparency, limited availability of live rates, opacity about bank margin. So lack of rates transparency. Whenever client goes to bank or call a bank to get the rate, what banks do? Bank dealer will quote you the net rate. But in reality, it's an inclusion of various components like cash spot, term spot, forward premium, or might be discount depending upon the type of transaction or currency. Another point is limited availability of live rates. What clients do, they just check on the Google for getting the rate from the bank. But the real-time rates are traded on the terminals like Thomson Reuters, Bloomberg, LLP, which are beyond the affordability of many clients. Another point is opacity about bank margin. What is bank margin? Bank margin is a fixed commission charged by the banks from their clients on each and every transaction. But as I have told you earlier, that banks what do? Banks do to quote you the net rate. But bank margin is also an inclusion in the net rate. And these bank margins are not transparently disclosed, because sometimes it also happens with clients that banks charge the bank margin, banks charge their commission from the clients depending upon the amount of transaction. Okay. So before proceeding, let me draw your kind attention to some important points, like bank and their clients are counterparties. Okay. So how banks and their clients are counterparties? Okay. If an exporter receives an receivable and he needs to convert their currency in INR, okay, what will he do? He will sell his foreign currency to the bank and bank will buy it. And in case importer needs to make a payment outside the India, he will go to the bank or call a bank to get to buy the currency, and bank will sell this currency to the client. Okay. So whatever it means, whatever will be the profit for a client, it will be a loss for the bank, and vice versa. Most of the time, clients have told me, sir, forex rates calculations are complex, but it's not like that. Users just need to understand some basic concepts. I understand this thing. It might get tricky in case of if you are doing a transaction in yen or CHF. Okay. Another slide is about types of arithmetic tools in forex rates calculation. Okay. It's spot, term, cash, forward, bid, ask, and spread. What is spot? Spot is also known as the interbank rate, and it settles after 2 working days. And term is settled after 1 working day. Okay, if I talk about cash type of transaction, most of the transaction generally happens in the cash because it settles on the transaction day itself. For example, if an exporter receives an receivable in US currency and he goes to the bank or goes to the bank and he converts his currency in INR terms in value cash, then his account, his or her account will get credited with that amount, with INR amount, by today itself. If I talk about forward is used as an hedging tool by importers or exporters for hedging their currency risk. It can be booked on anticipated basis or contracted exposure basis. What is anticipation? Anticipated basis? Okay. So if importer or exporter have an expectation that they will receive some orders in future, then clients can book the hedge their currency as on the anticipated basis. And if clients have some already have some document lying with them, then they can hedge their currency risk on the contract exposure basis. Okay, let's move on to the next slide. Bid ask spread. What is bid? Bid price trading for selling the currency in the market to the banks, and ask and bid is used for the used by the exporters, and ask is used by the importers for buying the currency from the bank. Okay, spread is the difference between the ask and bid price. Okay, if the liquidity is more, then the spread will be the less. For example, if you will check the USD INR currency, there is a spread of only 1 paisa. If you go to Euro INR, GBP INR, you will find out there is a spread of 2 paisa, 3 paisa, or might be 4 paisa. Okay. So here's the components of Forex rates. Spot rate, cash spot, term spot, premium, bank margin. As I have told you, spot rate is the basis of all types of transactions. Okay. And what about cash spot? Cash spot will be deducted only in the cash type of transaction, and term spot will be deducted in the term type of transaction, whether it is for importer or exporter. If I talk about the premium, it will get added in for both the things, for buying the currencies as well as for selling the currency. And bank margin is deducted for the exporters, and it will be added for the importers. There will be some additional components if a client is dealing in the cross currencies, like Euro INR, GBP INR, JPY INR. Then there will be an inclusion of spot of USD INR leg and Euro USD leg, GBP USD leg, or USD JPY. Okay. Let me show you one example of cross currency calculation. Okay. INR is fully converted to dollar for conversion of currencies other than dollar. An Indian client has to go through the USD INR leg and the cross currency leg. For example, if an Indian importer needs to make a payment to his German supplier, what will he do? He will check the ask side of USD INR leg, and he will check the ask side of Euro USD leg. After multiplication, he will get the spot rate, and for exporter, he or she just needs to check the bid side of both the legs. Okay, so I think you guys have understood this thing. Banks tries to overcharge their clients. So for this purpose, MyForexHi has launched his application. In this application, you will have the access to real time rates, and you will also have the bifurcation of all the components. On a single click, you can check the spot rate, what's the current spot rate, cash spot, and or premium or discount, depending upon the type of transaction. You can also audit your historical transaction on the MyForexHi application. It is also easily customizable. For example, if you have a margin of 2 paisa, 3 paisa, 5, might be 5 paisa, you can just enter your margin in MyForexHi application, and you will get the net rate after deducting or inclusion of your margin. Okay. And you might get to spot rate on different sites. Obviously it's delayed because it's traded on the terminals, but getting a premium, it's not an easy task. So MyForexHi application also provides you one whole year premium calendar for your better negotiation with the banks. Okay, guys, thank you. That's all from my side. Thank you. Thank you.